So you just bought yourself the Amazon Fire TV Omni and you need to know how to set it up. Let's dig into those picture settings. Hi everyone, I'm Caleb Dennison, and today we're gonna go ahead and dig into this TV, and I'm gonna give you my recommended initial picture settings for the television. With that said, everybody's needs are different. Your room might be bright, it might be dark, you might like motion smoothing, or you may hate it. Remember, this is just a starting point. From there, you can kind of play around with the settings to get exactly what you want. All right, let's dig into it. One of the things that I'm liking about the Amazon Fire TV Omni is that its picture settings are broken out based on whether you're talking about apps and video or HDMI ports. Now, in order to make any adjustments, you really want to see the effect of those. So rather than doing it from the picture settings in the settings menu, which intuitively you'd think that's what you want to do, you actually want to go into some content to see the ramifications of your decisions. So in this case, I'm gonna pull up YouTube and I've got a SDR video already queued up here. Let me press pause on that. And then we'll go into the picture settings. Press the settings button, go down to picture, and by default, we're gonna be in the standard mode. Now with the standard mode, what we can expect are some pretty dazzling settings, right? The backlight's maxed out at 100%. The dynamic backlight setting is on. If we go into advanced settings, what we'll notice is that the dynamic contrast is on and color temperature is standard. That's gonna be one of the big ones I would wanna change for personal preference. You'll also notice that some of the digital noise reduction that we have is set to medium. And then this is really important. Natural cinema is set to off. And action smoothing is maxed out. So if you like the soap opera effect and you like a cold color temperature, something that is very cool, blues tend to be very blue, whereas you don't get as intense reds, then this would be fine. The standard setting would be fine. And I know a lot of people are never gonna touch this stuff. And so this is how the TV is going to look by default. This again for SDR. Now, normally what I would do is go into the picture mode and I would choose movie. Let's get a look at that. Right off the bat, I noticed that it's warmed up the color temperature. The backlight is set at 80, so not dim, but definitely more suitable for a dimmer room. I think most people are gonna wanna max that out. But before we get into that, let's go into the advanced settings and have a look. We'll notice that the contrast and brightness are set 50 and 48. That's fine, I suppose I would leave that alone, unless I was doing some testing and found out otherwise that I'd wanna change it. Color temperature, warm, as I indicated. The noise reduction is set to low, so minimum of processing happening there. And natural cinema is set to on. You'll notice there is no option to go to action smoothing. It's been grayed out. Now I could turn off natural cinema, get access to the action smoothing and use, maybe 1, 2, 3, a little less of the smoothing effect than maxing it out at 10. Maybe that's gonna be a nice sort of balance between getting a smoother picture for fast moving sports, but without having serious soap opera effect. I'll let you decide what you wanna do. I think the smart move for anybody who really wants to dig into the settings and get the most out of the picture quality would be to go to the custom mode. This is what I would do at home. Now, right off the bat, you can tell we've got a much colder color temperature that we're working with. So let's go down. We notice that backlight is maxed out. So the brightest picture that we can get in SDR, I think that's gonna suit most folks. Go into advanced settings. Contrast and brightness set to 50 each. That's fine. I suppose we could bump the brightness down to 48 a little bit to match the movie mode if we wanted to. But what we really wanna hone in here on is color temperature. I would move this to warm for the most accurate color. Not everybody wants accuracy. Some people really enjoy the cooler color temperature and that's fine, go for it. The noise reduction again is set to medium. So I'm gonna bump that down to low to better match the custom setting and see what kind of effect that has. This is a point at which you would wanna experiment with things and see if you prefer a higher setting. Frankly, I don't think that the noise reduction is gonna be super effective anyway. Natural cinema is set to on by default, which is great. That's not gonna allow any action smoothing at all. And then gradation clear, this is gonna try and get rid of banding, is set to medium. And generally speaking, going with a midpoint on these kind of things is the best move. So that's SDR taken care of. We chose the custom setting and just customized some of the settings there. Let's go into an HDR video. So I've pulled up an HDR title on YouTube and pressed pause so that we can make some adjustments and really see the effect of those. We'll go into picture once again. It's in standard mode, but up top we notice that it's in HDR, so we are in the right mode. I'm going to go straight for the custom mode, just as we did before. I think movie is a very safe bet if you want something that's, again, mimicking the accuracy that most folks like myself would want. But let's go into custom and make some adjustments. So backlight maxed out, which I would expect for HDR. Dynamic backlight is turned off. I am going to play around with this, and in my full review, I'll talk about whether it's actually something that you want to utilize. I'm not liking what I'm seeing in the A-B comparison, so we're gonna leave that off for now. Color saturation, interestingly, is at 70. Again, I would need to take some measurements to see if this is really where I would want it, but that's deeper calibration stuff, not so much the basic settings that we're trying to get here. Contrast at 50, brightness at 50, both fine. Dynamic contrast is off, good. Gamma's at 0, tints at 50, color temperature standard, we'll switch that to warm, and then we'll take a look at sharpness. Interesting. This probably doesn't need to be anywhere. It's at 12 by default. Noise reduction back to low as we did previously for SDR, same here. And let's go down one more. Natural cinema is off and action smoothing is at 0. That's an interesting move considering that in SDR, it was the other way around. And gradation clear, medium. That looks like a good place to start for HDR. Now, let's go to Dolby Vision. And for that, I think we'll just pull something up on Netflix. Okay, now we're Netflix. We've pulled up a Dolby Vision title. You probably recognize it. Press the settings button. Hello, press the settings button. Yes, there we go. Picture, and we're in Dolby Vision mode. Dolby Vision bright, Dolby Vision dark, and then some very basic vivid, natural, and custom settings. This to me is interesting because it almost seems as if it would override the Dolby spec, which we definitely would not want to do. So, again, just sort of getting the initial settings, I'm gonna go with Dolby Vision Bright. It's very rare that I choose Dolby Vision Dark. You really need to be in a very dark room to need that so that you don't kind of get blasted out of your room. Backing out of that and into the individual settings within that preset for Dolby Vision Bright. Dynamic backlight is off as we've chosen elsewhere. Go into advanced settings. I'm expecting everything to be where we want it except maybe color temperature, which indeed is standard. I'm going to warm that up. Go a little bit further down. Noise reduction is off for both MPEG and standard noise reduction. Natural cinema is off and action smoothing is at 0. So again, I think you can toy around with choosing natural cinema, which should reduce some judder in 24p content, or you can leave it off and just reduce action smoothing to 0 if you don't want soap opera effect. And again, you can play around with the effectiveness of the action smoothing depending on what your personal preference is. Interestingly enough, gradation clear is turned off for Dolby Vision. That is by Dolby's request. So I'm going to leave it that way because I assume Dolby knows what they're doing when it comes to how they implement their picture quality on this TV. Now that takes care of apps. All you would need to do then is go into your HDMI inputs and again, do the same thing. Play SDR, play HDR. If you have a Dolby Vision capable Blu-ray player, then you would want to adjust Dolby Vision. Same if you're using the Xbox, for instance. Speaking of, let's see what happens when we connect an Xbox Series X. So we press the settings button, go down to picture, and it looks like we're in standard picture mode. So I'm not seeing any indication that there's an auto game mode. We'll go into game, and probably we're gonna wanna leave everything at default, but we'll double check it anyway. We're not in HDR now, but we could go into that later. Dynamic backlight off, color saturation 50, screen settings auto, advanced settings. Dynamic contrast is currently on. I'm gonna turn that off. The gamma and tint are at defaults. Color temperature is cool. I'm gonna warm that up. That looks a little bit more familiar to me. Sharpness setting, again. Why is this all over the place? Well, it's set at 30 now. We'll leave that, but I'm not sure that that's the right call. Noise reduction is turned off for both of these. Natural cinema off and action smoothing at 0. That looks just fine for me. Now, the HDMI input mode is currently at auto. Looks like we could force it down to HDMI 1.4 if we wanted to, or force it into HDMI 2.0. What we do notice here though is that HDMI 2.1 is not supported. So variable refresh rate, probably not gonna be an option here for us, even though we do have the option for eARC if we want it. Now, as long as we're in the Xbox, since we're in the game mode and we've made our final decisions on the picture settings there, this is now when you would wanna go into the HDR game calibration section and get things set up here. Now, before I do that, I just wanna double check my picture settings. We should be in an HDR mode since we're doing HDR calibration. Go into picture, and up top we do see that we're in HDR mode. That's good, but the picture modes reverted to standard. We wanted game, right? So looks like when we go into HDR on an Xbox, we have to go and do all the picture setting stuff again. Select game mode, double check everything is what we want. Under advanced settings, it looks like color temperature is once again at cool. We'll go to warm. Everything else is just fine. So lesson learned, before you make any kind of HDR settings on the Xbox, make sure that the TV has been set up correctly. And again, from here, you're basically just trying to get to the point where you can barely see those checker boxes for both the peak luminance and the black levels. Once that's done, you should be good to game in both Dolby Vision and HDR. Okay, there you go. That's where I would start if I was setting up this TV for myself. I think that's a good starting place for you, but don't be afraid to play around and find the picture quality settings that suit you best. Thanks as always for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video valuable. And if you did, please smash that like button so that we know to make more of these. And while you're here, might as well hit subscribe. We put out lots of great content, not just TV settings videos. And while you're here, here's two other videos I think you might like.